Lindholm moves it ahead. Just 22 years of age, one of the top young defensemen in the National Hockey League. Looks ahead to Ryan Garvin for Nate Thompson. In comes Mike Santorelli to pick it up now. Santorelli digs back in the corner. Now it's stolen away. Moved up to center ice, and away comes Perron for Anaheim. David Perron for Ryan Getzlaf. In, shoots, scores! Ryan Getzlaf snaps it home, and the Ducks take the lead.
Turcotte 2-on-1. Le Cavalier was wrapped up along with Getzlaf. And then when that's separated, that's when the Ducks had so much time. You see, right there, they're tied in the middle. Le Cavalier was flat-footed. He never catches up. In this situation, I would not doubt if Jonathan Quick is thinking pass, because Ryan Getzlaf is known to be a passer. But you see, it's taken away by Martinez, and the top corner is right there. Does Martinez get a piece of it? Does it go straight in? It looks like it's straight in right there, knowing what he wants on the play. But that all started in his own zone, where he was taken on the play initially by Le Cavalier, but Le Cavalier was knocked off balance from that point on. Turcotte.
To have that game seven over again. Now brought ahead by Getzlaf, along with Perron. Getzlaf in, sends it back in front. Perron scores! David Perron slides it by Jonathan Quick as he slides by Quick, and the LA goaltender is hot.
Well, Quick is claiming contact, but so far it has fallen on deaf ears. David Perron was acquired by the Ducks because he's an inside player. And watch the drive towards the net. There is contact with the right skate of Jonathan Quick. They're going to take a look at this.
Well, two things to look at here. Number one, did he kick the puck in? And number two, was there goalie interference?
Yeah, I think he's already going down, so I don't think that there's the turnover. Daryl Sutter just talking about the turnovers. You have everyone going one way, then the Ducks go back the other. I don't think Perron's going to get a kick against him because I don't see a distinct kicking motion. Is Gabrick responsible there for the push? That may be the reason for the contact.
You know, and it really boils down to, does the goaltender, is he able to make a play on the puck? The Ducks, they wanted the puck dropped.
Right.
They're yelling on the bench, drop the puck.
No, I think it's going to be dropped. But it's, to me, I don't see the kick. I see Gabrick having an effect as far as what's happening with the player sliding in, and they're going to count it.
Yep,
that's what it is. Turnover.
They got the word from the situation room. They went over. They talked to the timekeeper's bench. The referee put the thumbs up, said that yes, they said it's a good goal in Toronto.
And tried to move it in. Trevor Lewis backhands it to the line, but not out. Now picked out by Kessler, a centering pass. Perry shoots. Oh, what a save by Quick as he comes across to take one away there. Now Raquel back on it. Howdy pump there by DePray. Puck picked up. Moves it by Stewart. Stewart finds Garvin. In, shoots, scores! Ryan Garvin over the shoulder of Quick. And it's 3-0 Anaheim.
This looks like nothing, and then all of a sudden, it's something. You've got to make the opposition do something they don't want to do. Bang, Doughty gets knocked down, at least knocked off the puck. And look at the Ducks now. It's a shot that he gets inside the circle, so it's a good shooting area. I don't know if it can be shot any better. Watch this. Watch where this hits. It is absolutely perfect. Just inside the bar, inside the post. Jonathan Quick's in good position. Look at that. Both pads right at the top of the crease. And we're going to get a goaltender change.
Yeah, for just the second time this year, Jonathan Quick has been pulled from the net for the Los Angeles Kings. And Jonas Enroth will come in for him. So Quick is chased on 3 goals on 9 Anaheim shots.
And Brian, I don't know about you, but the two things I look at, where the shot was taken from, that was inside the circle, so I say good scoring area. Then I look at the position of the goaltender. Quick had good position. That was a perfect shot.
Yeah, it was a perfect shot, right in the crook of the arm. More than any other centerman in the league.
Carter, a long shot, rebound to Foley, backhand of the high and wide. Anaheim number one in the NHL on the penalty kill. Now Doughty, a long shot, scores! Doughty fires it home. It's deflected in front. And the moonshot goes over Gibson, and the power play goal has LA on the board.
Doughty was working as much as possible to change the angle of the shot, and he takes it across.
Well, here's the shot, and it's going to hit something in front here and pop right up in the air. Boy, it hits the back of Toffoli and pops right over the head of John Gibson. Boy, that's a great bounce for the Kings power play.
It hits the full.
Yeah, the back of the leg. No chance for the Gibson to reach up and snare that puck.
Yeah, he didn't see the release. He didn't see the contact with the back of the leg. Calf shot right there by Toffoli. And look at Gibson. He's still looking forward. The referee McCauley's over at the Anaheim bench right now. Look at him. He's still looking for. He finally realizes. I give Doughty credit for walking the line a little bit there to change the point of attack.
Play. Now Kopitar having the cheek. Kopitar hammered down there by Lindholm. And now Lindholm crossed that. Yeah, Lucic didn't like that. He's trying to start something. The play continues. Brought in now by Raquel Sinners. It's got right on goal by Maroon and 200 feet away.
Long term trying to buy him some room.
Perry drops it back to Fowler. Perry sent flying. Batman walks in. Back to Perry. In shoot. Oh, a glove save by Enrod.
What a stop.
Perry can't believe it.
Yep, he had half a net. Just couldn't get it over the left hand of Enrod.
40 seconds to go in the Anaheim power play. Kopitar battling for it. Picked out by Kessler. Back he goes. For Lindholm. Walks in. Lindholm fires. Scores! Hampus Lindholm, who started it all with a hit on Andrei Kopitar, pounds it home for a power play goal. And Anaheim.
It was the fake by Lindholm at the blue line. Watch Kopitar is going to kind of wave at him here. Puck comes back to Lindholm, and he's going to walk it to the middle of the ice. Kopitar thinks he's going back to the short side, and then he just hammers it, and the shot is perfect. And no way Enroth ever sees this. There are layers of Kings in front. Pat Maroon is in front of the goaltender Enroth. The Ducks power play. So yes, Lucic stands up for Andrei Kopitar. It ends up being a bad penalty that costs him a goal. And the reaction from Daryl Sutter says it all.
Yeah, Lucic trying to send the message, trying to look long-term. Lindholm looking short-term. They get to celebrate. You can see Enroth with Maroon in front. He was looking one way. The timing was perfect. The timing perfect for Anaheim. Enroth one way, the puck the other. Player. We all know inside the locker room that might change, but you know, publicly will not do it.
Toffoli swings ahead. Jeff Carter in. Shoot. Just missed wide. Gibson might have got a piece of that.
Yeah, caught the pipe. Caught the outside of the goalpost. Great speed through the neutral zone from Carter. And boy, he had a good step of clearance.
Here at LA has two shots on goal since. Kopitar drops it back. Lucic centers it. Oh, what a stop by Gibson. Loose puck to kick away. And Brown gets a chance. Gibson down. Makes the save. A furious scramble in the Anaheim crease. And John Gibson holds his ground.
That's Kings hockey there. That's what they want to do. That's what Brian was talking about. Getting traffic to the front of the net. And they had the speed once again. We haven't seen that until this period. Look at Lucic. He has time because everyone's backing off because of that initial speed. Brown doesn't get it for a moment here. The puck will be free in the crease. Gibson thinks he has it, but there it is. You see, in the skates, the exit takes Brown, so Brown can't get to the puck. Lucic takes a swing. It's under a defenseman's legs for a split second here. Cogliano's down. He's defending.
Cogliano makes a save there.
Yeah, he did. I mean, he's all the way back to his crease. And you see that both the Kings and the Ducks trying to see how many players they can squeeze into that blue paint. Gibson, calm, composed. Cogliano doing his job. You got to, hey, save a goal.
I think Cogliano made two stops. Yeah. Well, one on Brown and one on Lucic at the end.
Anyone? Is Lucic on it? Paddles there with Thompson. Centers for Brown with a shot. Goes off a stick. Bounces down to Kopitar. Oh! Chance for Martinez. He scores. Looks like Gibson got it. And with 23 seconds to go, the Kings have their second of the game. Scores his seventh of the year.
Sneaking down back door. That's the play that works here. Now, of course, it's going to be too little too late. Look at Kopitar just kind of touching across. Martinez is known for this. He's an explosive skater. When he gets there, Gibson does get a piece. But it's the unselfishness of Kopitar. I think Kopitar also realized he couldn't spin around to get a good shot. So he had to look for the next best option. That option was the backdoor play. Martinez slides it home. The Kings get back within two.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's they feel good. I mean, you only get a few. It's everyone feels good, whether it's even strength or not. But, you know, we played better as a group tonight, and our line was effective early and felt good.
You get that rush, obviously, up ice. Now, was there any part of you that wanted to pass it back?
A lot of me did. I'm pretty sure that's why Quick was leaning all the way over there. But, you know, it was nice to finally get, you know, actually rip one and put it past him.
Do you feel like you're playing closer to where you can be and should be?
Yeah, I feel better with the puck. And, you know, the last, you know, so basically since Christmas, it's felt a lot better. Puck's not going in the net, but our line's being effective. We're getting things done, and other guys are putting goals in the net. So.
What are you and David doing that's kind of clicking so well? Is there, you talked about
well, he just, this morning, yeah, I mean, it's one of those things. He's a puck handler. I mean, he hangs onto the puck. He's strong on it. He plays a lot like Parrish, to tell you the truth. I mean, they're both kind of pests out there and strong on the puck. And we got Stewie skating and getting us the puck. I mean, it makes my job a lot easier when he goes in every time as F1 and either coughs the puck up or gets it himself. So,
as a team, are you guys at the top of your game right now?
I don't know if we're at the top yet, but we're playing a lot better hockey. We just got to continue along the same path. You know, when we weren't scoring goals, we tightened things up defensively and found ways to win games. And we got to stick with that mentality when they're going in as well.